What's going on, DR? I'm Ben Brown.
And I'm Mitchell Guerrero. And here's this week's episode of DR News.
Come on, guys, let's get to work.
Yes, boss. Yes,
stand by. 5, 4, 3.
Yo, Mitch, you hear about any news in the world lately?
Not sure. Let's check it out with Brennan and Matt.
Good afternoon. This is World News. I'm Brennan Week.
And I'm Matt Ricker.
Now, today's episode is brought to you by Syntax. Now, Matt, can you tell everyone what Syntax is?
No, I can't, but I do know that it's not this.
We'll change with the same people and same policies that got us into the status quo. Another Latin word, status quo.
Say, Brendan, do you hear that?
Hear what?
That would be William Shakespeare rolling in his grave. And that's it for this week's World News. I'm Matt Ricker.
And I'm Brennan Week. Everyone have a great weekend.
Who's that teacher?
Sports, sports, sports with Joe.
And now here is this week's DR High Five Club recipients. Morgan Tanner enrolls in several AP and honors courses, working as a child caregiver, camp counselor, and assistant barn manager. Morgan plans to attend UMass Dartmouth and become a pediatric nurse.
Timothy Charette, being an active member of the Scheduling Committee, Spirit Week Committee, and the Junior-Senior Prom Separation Committee. Acceptance to Endicott College and Bridgewater State University. Timothy Charette plans to attend a four-year college and major in graphic design.
Hello. To add some educational value to the show, I'm going to fill your mind with some obviously important knowledge in just 20 seconds. Woo! A broken clock is right twice a day. Your foot is the same size as your forearm.
Yawning is contagious.
A strawberry is actually not a berry, but bananas and watermelons are. Nomophobia is the fear of not being able to use your cell phone.
I have that.
It's Mr. Parente!
We've been checking up on our Twitter, and you let us know which teacher you'd like to see on this week's Teacher Highlights.
Tweet, tweet.
Hey DR, I'm Will Baresi, and this week's teacher highlight is Mr. Parente. So, Mr. Parente, how long have you been teaching at DR?
14 years, approximately.
14 years, wow. So, if you weren't a teacher, what else would you be doing right now?
I'd probably be running my own business, which I kind of do on the side, but I'd probably be doing that full time.
So, what have you found to be the best way to get kids to learn?
I'd say positive motivation. Showing students what the relevance of the material is to the real world, how they might be able to use it in their lives, getting to know my students as people, using some of those key interests to help them see how it might fit into their lives, meeting them at the level they're at.
Well, that's very interesting. Well, that's all the time we have for today, DR. I'm Will Baresi with Mr. Parente. Back to the studio.
And now Jordan, Corey, and Trenton went around to ask students what their snow ideas were.
Welcome to Student Interviews. I'm Trent Saliba.
And I'm Jordan, here to bring you your answers.
What's your favorite thing to do in the snow?
I like to build igloos and underground tunnels to Trenton's house.
I like to eat yellow snow.
Build a
snowman. Honestly, I really don't like the snow. I just want to move to Miami with my husband, LeBron James.
Well, I like to stay inside, light a roaring fire, cuddle up with my little man bear here and drink hot cocoa.
Definitely sledding. I like to eat it.
And that's it for...
Hey, whoa. First Joe steals my line and now you're completely cutting the skit?
Chill on it, bro. It's still scheduled to air.
Oh, well, here's my skit for this week.
Who else but Ben?
You want to hear some jokes about snow? Where do polar bears keep their money?
No idea.
In snowbanks.
Quiet.
What kind of cake did Frosty get for his birthday? one with lots of frosting.
And that ends this edition of DR News. I'm Ben Brown.
And I'm Mitchell Guerrero. And have a good weekend, DR.
Enjoy the snow.
Dig it!